Welcome to Chem Help ASAP. Let's build upon the Michaelis-Menten equation to find an easier way to determine enzyme kinetic parameters. On the left is a V versus S plot from a previous video along with the Michaelis-Menten equation. This is great, but it's kind of hard to figure out exactly what Km and Vmax are from the graph. Vmax is the plateau, but estimating the plateau is kind of difficult. Km is the substrate concentration that gives a rate of 1/2 Vmax. Km is right about here somewhere. Again, it's hard to determine. Is there an easier way to determine accurately Km and Vmax? Yes, there is. At the top right is a new equation, the Lineweaver-Burk equation. It is a double reciprocal equation that converts our V versus S curve into a 1 over V, 1 over S line. So the Lineweaver-Burk equation fits Y equals mx plus b. The y-axis, or the y-values, are 1 over v. The x-axis, the x-values, are 1 over s. The slope, m, is km over vmax. The y-intercept, b, is 1 over vmax. Note that the y-intercept is a theoretical value. You only reach the y-intercept if 1 over s is 0, which requires infinite substrate concentration. Fitting a line like the Lineweaver-Burk equation is far easier than fitting a curve like the Michaelis-Menten equation. Let's walk through these steps. Here on the left are three V versus S points. We never determine Vmax and Km with just 3 points, but this is just a demonstration. We can take the reciprocal of each value, and now we have 1 over V, 1 over S data points. We don't need to make a graph, but we can see to the right what these three data points look like once plotted with a best fit line drawn through them. The equation of the best fit line is shown. Obviously, these data are not real experimental data points. Again, you don't need to make a graph, though it's nice to see that the data points are approximately linear. If the data are not linear, then A, the data may not be valid, or B, the enzyme may not obey Michaelis-Menten kinetics. From the y-intercept, which is 1 over Vmax, you can determine Vmax. Once you have Vmax in hand, the slope, in this case 1,000, can be used to determine Km. If you skipped making a graph, you can always use the built-in slope and intercept functions on your 1 over V, 1 over S data point pairs. This is great. Now that we understand a bit more about enzymes and kinetic data, we can think about how to use these ideas for drug discovery. I hope this video helped firm up your understanding of enzyme kinetics. Please subscribe, like, leave a comment, or ask any questions you might have. Take care.